So now, we are going over lesson 8.3, which is, we use the term FOIL. It's basically double distribution. So what's happening is we have two sets of parentheses. Each set of parentheses has a binomial. Okay?
Can I give you the answer?
No. By the way.
I have the orange one.
By the way. Another way to write x plus 2 times x plus 2 is x plus 2 squared. If I had x plus 2 squared, I would need to write it out and write x plus 2 and x plus 2. Hint, hint. For those of you who do not have me, I think there's a quiz out there that you might see in your future that has a problem where it's not this, but it's another number, x plus 2 squared. A lot of kids will do, oh, x squared and 2 squared is 4. They'll put that as the answer. That's not the answer. If you have something like this, you need to break it out to look like this. Hint, hint, if you don't have me and you have quiz, it might be up.
Yes.
Okay, so FOIL means we're going to multiply. This helps us keep track of how we're multiplying, because when we have this, basically we have to multiply every term by every other term. The F stands for first. The first term in the first set of parentheses is X. The first term in the second set of parentheses is X. So when I multiply X and X, I get X squared, correct? O stands for outside. When I multiply the numbers that are kind of on the outsides of the parentheses, that's x and 2, I get a positive 2x, or 2x, correct? When I multiply now the i's, those are the insides. So like this and this, in this case 2 times x is again
2x.
The last numbers in the parentheses, 2 and 2, I multiply them together and I get 4. So technically what I have is I have x squared plus 2x plus another 2x plus a 4. You will start to notice that typically these two terms are like terms, meaning I can combine them. So x squared, 2x plus 2x is 4x. That would be the answer for number 2. Okay? I'm going to jump to number 6. So for number 6, the problem is n minus 5, or the quantity of n minus 5, and the quantity of n plus 1. I'm multiplying them together. I'm taking two binomials. Remember, binomials is an expression with two terms, and I'm multiplying them together. So I use this FOIL acronym to help me keep it all straight. My first terms are an n and an n. What's n times n? What's n times n? N squared.
Good job, Caleb.
What's n times negative times 1? What's n times 1? Just 1n or just n? What's negative 5 times n?
Negative
5n. And what is negative 5 times positive 1?
Negative 5.
So I'm going to put these all together, and I can combine these two, right? Because they're both just an n. So I have n squared. Think of this as a positive n minus 5n. So if I have a dollar, but I need to give away 5, how many am I left with?
Zero.
Well,
-4.
-4.
Do I get another ticket?
Credit card? Good question. Caleb said, how do you give away money you don't have? It's called a credit card. When you charge money on a credit card, you are giving money you don't have. You are saying, I'll pay you later. Sometimes you actually have the money to pay off the credit card bill at the end. Sometimes you don't. And when you don't, they'll just charge you more money. My last term was -5, correct? So to write the answer, it's n squared minus 4n minus 5. 10. I'm going to jump to number 10. Number 10, my handwriting is going to be really bad, so bear with me. That's a cursive L.
Why are you writing in cursive?
Because it's kind of in cursive on the paper. Okay? Plus, it's if I do 1, if I write it like a print L, then it really gets confusing. Okay. What is 2L times L?
3L.
That would be, if I was adding, 2Ls plus an L is 3L. What's 2? What?
1L.
2L what? Okay, there's an L here and an L here. That makes 2L squared. You following me? So, now, guys, I'm changing my format here. I'm not writing FOIL down the side here. I'm just keeping track. This is my first term, right? The next is my outside. What's 2L times -4? What's 2 times -4?
-8.
Sit down, Christian. And there's an L here and no variable here, correct?
Yeah.
So that's -8L. What's 5 times L?
Plus 5
what?
L.
And what's 5 times -4?
-20.
So 2L squared, -8L plus 5L is what?
-3L. -20.
Okay, -20. So that is number 10. Number 14. 2m plus 2 over 3m minus 3. You can tell me how to do it. Well, then the answer doesn't do us any good. Yeah. So I'm first multiplying the first terms.
Okay, so that would be 2m times 3m.
Yes, and what is that?
6m
squared. Now what would I do?
You would do
2m and -3.
Yeah.
-6m, because that's my outside term.
Yeah.
Then I would do 2 times 3m.
6m.
So, in this case, my -6m and my 6m cancel out, correct?
Yeah.
And I get 6m squared minus
6.
Okay? Do we get the idea? Or do we need to do a few more? Good. We'll find out on Tuesday when you do this as a review activity.